Hello, lovers. This is Adrienne Meltzer and her hit Parade. And this is another neat, sweet hit by your favorite and mine, The Platters. Smoke gets in your eyes.
Old-time radio, sitting at home in your easy chair, listening to your velvet-voiced host playing your favorite song. Network radio took something of a beating when television was born, and both radio and television have changed a lot since then. But what's in our electronic future? If you're thinking radio on television, you may be right. But if you haven't seen cable television's MTV, then you don't know that the future is already here.
Ready on the floor, Steve.
Two.
One. Up on one and cue.
You're with MTV Music Television, the world's first video music channel in stereo. This is MTV Music Television. I'm Nina Blackwood, and I've got some music news for you. What I do is very similar to what a disc jockey does, only I'm on camera, so hence the term VJ as opposed to DJ.
Nina Blackwood, in her 20s, actress, musician, and now on MTV Music Television, a video jockey.
I would say that MTV conceivably could be the future of rock and roll, which sure does sound impressive. I'm going to move on. We'll do some music right here from a band called The Specials. At MTV, this is Rat Race.
Mark Goodman, in his 20s, former radio DJ and program director, now for MTV, and get used to this term, video jockey.
We can do things that radio has not been able to do.
Maybe so. MTV is Warner Amex's $20 million adventure into the cable television frontier. Five VJs bringing you a mixture of video music and rock and roll news. 24 hours a day, every day. So what exactly have we here? TV radio? Radio TV? Or something else? The man credited with developing MTV is Bob Pittman, also in his 20s.
We had a choice to go. We could either take music and try and make it fit the format of TV, the form of TV, or we could reinvent the form of TV to make it match music, which is what we did. When we first started, we had a teleprompter, and they all read it, and they made no mistakes at all, and we blocked the shots. We said, boy, this sure looks stale. Doesn't look like rock and roll to us.
So to get that rock and roll feeling, out went the scripts, out went stage directions, and just let it roll.
Coming to one, in five,
two,
three.
Coming to one,
two.
From MTV Music Television, Guitar Whiz Lee Ritenour and Mark Goodman with you. This is not television.
What is
what
it?
We do. This is something completely different.
Come on!
They're revolting. Hey, no, they're not revolting.
Yow, please!
Oh, my leg. I'm wounded. We'll have to break for commercials now. Please come back afterwards. It's craziness. I mean, you saw what was happening in the studio. That doesn't happen on a normal set anywhere. So yeah, we do anything we want.
So what if you cut a person's head off? So what if you do these things which are taboo and awful in TV to do? I mean, oh, it's a cardinal mistake. The people out there don't know. And for 2 seconds, it doesn't matter. What matters is the enthusiasm.
There's a little picture that's going to come up there that I'll show you.
They don't have the picture.
They don't have the picture?
No.
Oh, heck.
Time around.
Okay, that's too bad. But anyway, it turns out he tried to tell them and they didn't believe him. It was Ajax to clean his guitar. I mean, very simply. And I'm sure a lot of... Oh, shh. These guys are so jaded.
You just roll with... If there's a mistake, fine. You know, so what? You know, it's not going to ruin anything. We just keep going and just...
Yeah.
Like a play, like in a theater, you know, when, like, the curtain falls at the wrong place.
You can figure it out. Just take the tree off. Anyway, okay.
In just a couple of moments, we will have music news. I'll be talking... We're talking about the demise of the television studio.
Okay, this is MTV Music Television, and I'm Nina Blackwood, and I've got some music news for you. And I heard a gong, too, as we went off. I thought that was pretty funny.
What?
Huh?
Of course, you all remember Chubby Checker. Hey, let's twist again, right?
The fearless and frenetic approach seems to be working. MTV is carried by 250 cable systems nationwide. Even though the New York-based show cannot be seen in Manhattan yet, MTV claims to have 3 million viewers tuning in to the music form of the 80s, video rock. Record companies may hold MTV's trump card. They provide the videotapes that keep MTV on the air.
Music was the thing that just tied everything together. It was the reason that you cut school, you know. It was the reason that you did anything, you know. It was the joy of your life. There was school and there was your parents and there was, you know, this cheap car that never worked right that was yours that you hated but you needed, but the car had a radio, you know.
MTV is putting a picture tube in that radio, and the VJs are driving the car into unknown territory.
In a way, you know, it's a little bit shocking when somebody says, okay, go be yourself, because it's like, film, you know, you can have take after take and whatever, but we're doing is pretty much almost live, you know, and there you are with a camera, and the camera reads your eyes. I mean, you can't disguise what you're thinking, you know, so it is very naked.
Can we get a close-up of this? I try and be as much me as I can. Music has always been the way that I relate in social situations. I always can bring it back to a song somehow. Whatever the conversation is, I can always wind up with a dangling conversation. Or, you know, I've always been able to express myself better in terms of music.
And for a generation of rock music lovers who share that sentiment, MTV just may be a dream come true.
You make a man of dreams come true.